okay if I'm not interrupting anything. Yeah, so GRL, I didn't know the name in the very past. I know it since a couple of years, but maybe for the colleagues and participants which don't know GRL or yourself, maybe you want to introduce yourself briefly and what GRL is doing.
Good evening, good morning, everybody. My name is Vamshi Kandalla. I am the Chief Strategy Officer for Granite River Labs, based in Santa Clara, the Silicon Valley. We are a test engineering and automation solutions vendor with various locations all over the world. And we recently opened up our German office and lab in Karlsruhe. So basically, we are neighbors to Weichen. We concentrate on various markets worldwide. We offer an important testing and validation service ecosystem for most markets. We concentrate on consumer data centers, enterprise networking, mobile, and now automotive networking. So we specialize in the end-to-end compliance and test portfolio markets, if you will. We are especially interested in automotive Ethernet. Our background is automotive. And we're looking forward to essentially expanding and providing a key element of automotive testing, along with the other standards that we provide, which is USB, DisplayPort, high-speed SerDes, et cetera. That's what we do, and we're really looking forward to taking this forward.
Great, thanks for the introduction. I see some equipment exhibited here, so do you want to showcase something in detail?
Yes, yes. So we have a lot of stuff to talk about here, but I think a good segue is what 10-based Ethernet seems to be the flavor going forward in automotive Ethernet. I think my colleagues at BMW, colleagues at Renesas, they spoke about 10-based Ethernet from a development as well as a solutions viewpoint. We are here to expand that into the testing and compliance space. So we are with our partners, which is Rodian Schwartz, the gentleman here. We are partnering with GEPOF along with Microchip. We are showcasing a 10-based Ethernet test setup, which I will talk about going forward. In addition, we're also showcasing GEPOF's show and tell for their multi-gigabit, or what should I say, gigabit Ethernet or optical fiber, GEPOF testing. We'll talk through that. In addition, we are also showcasing our wired and wireless charging test compliance testers. Essentially, we are an authorized USB and Qi authorized tester. So we're talking through that, and I'll also mention a little bit of that. But the goal is to expand on the automotive Ethernet ecosystem through 10-based Ethernet and then do multi-gigabit service as we go along. So here, let me just talk you through what we are showing. So the test setup typically, as I said, mentioned before, we're using a microchip evaluation board. We're also using a standard controller in this scenario, a Raspberry Pi. We have a fixture from Rodian Schwartz, which is a simple setup. It's connected through a Rodian Schwartz 6 gigahertz scope with the test automation. So the testing is already running in the background. It's already doing that. There's a test spec. GRL, for those that do not know, authored the 10-based Ethernet PMA spec for Open Alliance. This is TC14. So these tests are running based on that. So you already see that there's some signaling happening in the background. You will essentially see that what is already passed, what's already failed, is already taken care of. And here, if I just go forward, you will see the test report, which hopefully my arms will stop shaking enough to move. It is not moving, that's fine. So this is the test sample report, which essentially showcases all the results that I've seen so far.
So it's auto-generated.
It's auto-generated. It's a part of the test automation that is a part of the setup from Rodian Schwartz. So where we are really interested in to try and expand that into multi-gigabit, this particular scope can support up to 10 gig. And as GRL, our expertise is in SerDes. We at GRL test up to 50 gigabaud for data centers. So we know how to test out SerDes for automotive really well. And that's something we're looking forward to. That's why we have the partnership that I mentioned with GEPOF, with Microchip, with Rodian Schwartz, and the other vendors as we go along. Right? So having said that, you know, moving from automotive Ethernet, both as in optical fiber as well as copper, I'll spend some time on charging. So the new, let's say, consumer experience within a next generation car includes charging, either wired or wireless. The next generation connected car includes wireless charging, which is based on a spec, which is through what's called a wireless power consortium, which can be up to 5 watts or 15 watts. So what we're showcasing here is a 5 watt base station charger for a charging controller. So here I have my iPhone, assuming somebody's driving. The phone is right next to the console, next to the driver. It automatically charges. The key message here is not the charging. The key message is that this compliance tester is able to immediately look for what the capacity of the charging is within the phone. This is the iPhone 12S. Mm-hmm. So essentially, this can support up to 5 watt to make sure there's nothing untoward going on. There are various coils supporting it. End of the day, this provides confidence to the system integrator and the tier one that their wireless console, wireless charging console, is designed as per the spec. And for this compliance tester, which is a complicated tester, GRL is the second solution approved by the wireless power consortium to make mm-hmm. it happen. Right? And then the previous solution to, again, wireless is the wired charger, using USB. This is already available in almost all the automotive cars in this case. So here it's a similar scenario. Wherein USB-powered delivery and quick charging, which is common to everybody. So we provide a compliance tester for that. In addition, we also provide test services that support for those customers wanting to do pre-compliance testing. They can come to the labs in various locations to make it happen. Right? So again, where we come in is to provide end-to-end services. The goal is to make sure the important testing and compliance ecosystem is covered. Mm-hmm. We have seven locations, as I mentioned. 8 locations in Karlsruhe, and I know a lot of the vendors here are looking for alternative, so I welcome them to visit us in the lab. We have a local presence, we have local partners, and mm-hmm. my colleague Lutz is based in Karlsruhe, so we can support people as they see fit. And we will be in this for the long run, looking forward to level 4 and level 5 of the connected car with in-vehicle networking and what I call a consumer experience with all the charging and display solutions.
Mm-hmm. Great. Thank you very much. It's always good to have alternatives, more companies, competitors in the market. It's good to know. Maybe from your end, is this the first event you attend in person or?
No, not really. I've been here since 2017, the first one in San Jose, that's a local event. Then I've been coming to the Munich events before. In fact, as a good segue, my last event in person was the 2019 end of Feb event at the Westin Hotel. And the new event after COVID is this event. So bookended by the automotive events, which is good for everyone. And of course, we're really happy to be here to basically showcase what we're capable of.
Great. Thanks. Thank you very much for showcasing this in your booth here. And with that, I would move on to our last but not least exhibit.